बेटा हुआ, बेटा हुआ, बेटा हुआ।
A boy is born, a boy is born, a boy is born. This is the 2nd of July, 1972. Zulfikar Ali Bhutto and Indira Gandhi have signed the Simla Accord, and a message has to be sent on telex to Delhi. So the message is coded, a boy is born, beta hua, if the agreement is signed successfully. If by chance the agreement, if by chance the agreement was unsuccessful, then the planned coded message was, beti hui, beti hui, beti hui. This is the situation. So that's why perhaps there's been so much confusion also. The Congress-led UPA government has been totally confused in the last 3-4 months, because if you look at December, the Criminal Law Amendment Act of 2012, then the unfortunate rape in Delhi, then the Verma Committee, who did such a wonderful job in 3 weeks, then we had an ordinance in 2013 which had no mention of the word rape in it. Then we come now to the Criminal Law Amendment Bill 2013. In 3 months, we've come to 3 dissimilar bills, legislation. So I just begin to wonder, do they legislate in haste and repent in leisure, just like they did in Tada? But overall, I would say that my party is happy with this reasonably good law. And I'd appeal to so many of my friends in the media also, please don't make this a debate between 18 and 16, because suddenly this has become the focus of the debate, 18 and 16. And ma'am, let me focus on some of the good things in this law. The first one, of course, because of the limited time, I'm just going to go very quickly on each one, is 375, the broadening the definition of rape. In other words, penal intercourse is not the only way now, because there have been some sordid stories in the last 10 years or so about all kinds of instruments being penetrating a woman's vagina. So that is great that the definition of rape has been truly broadened. A consent for once has an explanation. Consent for once has an explanation, and this is very, very welcome. And I'll tell you why. Because otherwise, a woman had to be actually to prove, you know, either through marks on her body or it scratched her. So at least now there's that comfort where she doesn't need to go and prove this, because the downside of that is this a loose woman, because you don't have any marks, so you kind of invited me. Now that's a very positive sign. The third one, which we find is extremely positive, on the new offenses, disrobing. Did a little reading on this, and Dalit women are disrobed often enough. Acid attack, we keep talking about what happened in December, but I take members back to that very, and it's only one case, but it's a very, very brave girl called Shonali Shakti, the girl who had acid thrown on her face and her whole life got changed. She's a brave girl. And so acid attacks, disrobing, stalking and voyeurism, good. Now I know there's a lot of myths, and some people are scared that the offenses of voyeurism and stalking will trap innocent men. And to be frank, there is some reason to be a little concerned about this. But overall, when we are talking about observing a woman, think of that woman who goes to an open toilet somewhere on the fields, you know, and there's somebody waiting for her. So I think we should look at stalking and voyeurism in the broader sense. And if the men here are a little scared that this will be misused, I'm sure we have a belief in the ladies of India that this will not be misused, and this will be a positive development. There are issues on stalking and voyeurism, but I think overall it's very good, because if you look at the case of Priyadarshini Matu, if there's no offense for stalking, see, we need to understand one thing. Rape is the top of the pyramid. A man doesn't rape a woman suddenly one night. You build it up from the bottom of the pyramid. How many girls or boys have not been groped in a bus in the city? I'll make an honest confession, ma'am. When I was 13, I was groped in a Calcutta bus. What do? You don't feel like telling anybody. But the idea here is there has to be that social awareness. And this is not just passing a law. The social awareness has to come. Like I gave you the example of the bus. If you see somebody in a bus who's been groped, the lady first needs to scream out loud, and then people will be socially aware. The schools have a role to play. The media have a role to play. And the implementing authorities. Now, the implementing authorities, here again, the government has rushed through this because there is also a question of funding. There is money. The states will handle this, but I'm afraid the states were not given enough time, 72 hours you reply. So I think the government will need to put its money where its mouth is. If it really wants to create a social awareness, it needs to earmark some funds to make this social awareness possible. And one more quick point I want to make on hospitals. That's good. There's a good and there's a bad. The good part is that the woman who's in this traumatic state does not need to go to a hospital and register an FIR. Good. Okay. The hospital needs to do the FIR. But the dangerous part is, and here, please take note, sir, the government will have to spell out a reimbursement formula for practitioners. Otherwise, I'm afraid this provision every time will be challenged in court. I'll conclude. Sir, ma'am, the three most favorite people in my life are all women. My wife, my mother, actually my mother, my wife, and my daughter. And they've been listening to this, and I've been talking to them, and they've heard, I said, what would you like to be? You know, we talk about women being deified, they're gods, they're sisters, they're mothers, all very well. They need to be what they really are. They're half the earth, they're half the sky. All these women, we owe to them. Let's make them citizens of India. Thank you.
Thank you very much. More for sticking to your time. It's very good.